Green Bay, Wisconsin, the birthplace of the legendary Green and Gold, is also home to the largest freshwater estuary in the entire world. Fox River and Bay of Green Bay have attracted people to Northeast Wisconsin for generations and have served as an essential natural resource for those who call the region home. Agriculture is integral to the local economy. Approximately 30% of Wisconsin's milk is produced by farmers here in the Northeast. While it's true that the region's strong agricultural presence has contributed to sediment and nutrient loading in local waterways, members of the Fox Demo Farms Project are committed to being a part of the solution.
Here in the Fox River watershed, our greatest concerns are the total suspended solids and the total phosphorus loads that are going into Green Bay. And so we sit in a unique spot where agriculture plays a major role in addressing those two factors, the phosphorus and the suspended solids. And with the demonstration farms, these six farms have really taken it upon themselves to look at new approaches and new practices to address these two issues that are occurring in the Bay.
Today we're at Tynedale Farms. Tynedale Farms is one of six demo farms that we have in the lower Fox River Basin. Over time, we've lost a lot of the organic matter in these soils. We want to try and rebuild these soils. And with the no-till or limited-till practices that we're asking producers to do, we're going to build those organic matter levels over time.
Went to no-till planting. We no-till everything in that we possibly can. We do a little bit of tillage, but very minimal tillage.
Here we got tillage radish. This tillage radish is 16 inches in length. This will help break up the soil compaction in the ground, but yet also feed the insects and break down for the next season, and this will die over winter.
We started rotational grazing a year ago. The first year we grazed about 25 acres with 25 animals, and this year we expanded to about 100 acres. We have, I'd say, about 100 animals out on pasture.
Some benefits to rotational grazing are that cattle, you don't have to make the feed and bring it to them. It's out in the field already. They can help themselves, and you don't have to worry about hauling out manure or anything. It's already out where you need it. It's a time saver and a money saver.
We're working with three different pieces of equipment that we wanted to take, and instead of making three different passes over a field, we take and turned it into a one machine, a one pass machine. So we're putting nitrogen on our corn, we're interseeding our cover crop, and we are doing a cultivation pass, all in one pass.
I've been using frost seeding in March in the spring, and then I've been using my no-till drill in the fall on the soybean ground and the corn ground after it comes off.
We've only been monitoring edge of field runoff up here for about 5 years, but we're learning some really interesting things. And first and foremost is that sediment loss is an issue up here. We're seeing sediment losses that are quite a bit higher than what we typically see throughout the rest of Wisconsin. The theme here is that if farmers can do a better job at controlling sediment loss, they're also going to control phosphorus, and that's going to improve water quality in Green Bay.
We've had a number of field days where we've had great turnouts at those events, and so it may be at one of the demo farms and we are able to pull in 60, 70 other producers that come in to be able to view a practice, to ask those one-on-one questions of the producer, and to be able to take what was learned back to their farm and either implement it, tweak it, and implement something a little bit different that fits their system.
If you're stuck on if you should do it or shouldn't do it, I would just ask a neighbor or find a field that somebody else did. Somebody's always doing one somewhere, and kind of learn what they're doing.
Just track your costs and track what you're getting for yields. I mean, you'll see it. It'll come.
What motivated me was what my dad ultimately taught me. Take care of your land, and your land will take care of you.
I want to make sure that the dairy industry and agriculture does their part to make sure that we stepped up to the plate and other people will follow to do that. If I don't see the impact of it, my kids will, of my actions that I'm doing here today.
Here at Van Wedding Farms, we've been farming this property or this land for 5 generations. Hopefully the practice that we're using to benefit the soil and stop erosion, that they can continue to farm with the land they have.
I see year after year the changes in it. It's exciting to see that. And that's what I enjoy about it.
Our efforts with the Fox River Demonstration Farms ultimately leads to the success of this water system. We all together support the idea of protecting our watershed, our water, and our future resources for future generations.
The Fox Demo Farms Project is working to restore our natural resources so that future generations can continue the tradition of sustainable agriculture here in Northeast Wisconsin. Help us share their stories and support their tremendous efforts. Thank you to the farmers on the ground who are making a difference every day in helping our land and improving our water resources.